And welcome back to the second half of this afternoon's contest between the Sam Houston Bearcats and the Western Illinois Leathernecks. Everyone, I'm Rod Sydlik, and alongside me, Randy McIlvoy. A good first half. The Bearcats leading it 21-10. Some good defense for the Bearcats, and they can come away with a designated Southland Conference victory here this afternoon. You've got some halftime stats.
Just a couple to pass on to you at halftime for Sam Houston. Reggie Lewis, 13 of 20, 230 yards, 305 yards of total offense for the Bearcats, and only one penalty called on them for 5 yards. On the other side for Western Illinois, for the quarterback for Western Illinois, 10 of 16, 170 yards. Paul Singer, 10 of 16 for the Leathernecks. Bearcats kick it off. Leathernecks return it, number 30.
He will have good yardage once again, tackled on the play. 41 up for Sam Houston.
That's William Brazil on the run back for the Leathernecks.
Bubba Shaw, backup tailback, gets the tackle on the special team. So Paul Singer of Western Illinois will lead the offense back out onto the field.
Very important for the Bearcat defense here to stop him right away here in the second half.
Pass is complete over on the far sideline. Number 10, Chris Earl, takes a shot from Meldon Mickles up from his strong side cornerback spot, but another good gain, about 8 yards for Paul Singer and Western Illinois. As you mentioned, total offense, 305 yards for Sam Houston, 212 yards for Western Illinois. We mentioned two good quarterbacks, and that's exactly what you got in the first half. 230 yards for Reggie Lewis, 171 for Singer. Once again looking to throw. That pass is complete. Mike Borich, as he is out of bounds across the 40-yard line. Once again, Singer working on Meldon Mickles, the senior cornerback, one-year lineman from Beaumont, Charlerton Pollard on the coverage for Sam Houston.
And right off the bat here in the second half, Paul Singer again is on target, 2 of 2 already. 14:40 left in the third period. Ball on the 41-yard line of Western Illinois, but they're driving.
Hand the ball straight up to the middle to the fullback. That's Brett Grimshaw. He will have short yardage, maybe a gain of only one, maybe no gain on the play, depending on where they spot the football. Give him a gain of 1 yard on the play, and that will bring up a second down and 9.
Bearcat defense again has to be commended. That defense has turned it around the last 3 to 4 weeks. Not only 10 points here in the first half today. Let's see what they do in the second half. Second down now for Western Illinois.
As they go with 3 wide receivers to the left side, Singer under pressure, has a man, completes the pass over on the far sideline to number 83. That's Tom Braggs, tight end. He will have the reception and gain about 4 yards on the play. It's still going to be about 6 yards short of the first down. So third down and 6, and right here to start the second half, a big defensive play for Sam Houston as they need to shut this Western Illinois offense and not let them get momentum here starting the second half. Williams split wide to the left side. Beebe wide to the right. Now Singer looking to throw. Ball is almost intercepted. Billy Anderson had it go in and out of his hands. Ball intended for number 2, Steve Williams, a sophomore from Davenport, Iowa. Incomplete in a punting situation. Nice defensive work that time by the Bearcats.
Good job by the defense. That's what they had to do. Start the second half, hold them. Make them punt the ball, get the ball back on offense and put it to work, see what you could do. Best thing to do to get this Western Illinois team down, score points. Get them down by a lot,
Krause,
keep them down.
Krause had 3 punts for a 48-yard average in the first half. Billy Anderson lets it go over his head. It will go out of bounds. Nice leg into that punt. The net won't be as much because they'll bring it back to the 20, but Krause has really got a strong leg. The sophomore from Kewaunee, Illinois on the punt for Western Illinois. So now the Bearcats back on offense and their chance to perhaps gain a little momentum here to start the second half.
James Short still in there for the Bearcats. He'll start it off. Maybe he'll have a better second half than he did the first half. couple of balls he should have caught in the first half, bounced off of him. Let's see what he can do now.
Henry wide to the left side, Keith Willis wide to the right, shorts and Turner the tailbacks behind Reggie Lewis. Hand the ball straight up the middle to Turner. Turner now fighting for yardage, and he will have about 2 yards on that play. Tough going inside. 44 off the bottom of the pile. Marty Lomolino, the right side linebacker, senior from Gridley, Illinois, up to make the stop for Western Illinois. Gave him a gain of 2-3 yards on the play and bring up a second down and 7.
James Lopez in for Sam Houston. Number 18, Keith Willis, comes out, grabs another play. Second down and 7 for Sam Houston.
Lopez wide to the left side. Now Victor Henry goes wide to the right. Tight end split is tight on the right side. That's Rick Eggleston. Now back to throw. Lewis trying to avoid the rush. Spins out of trouble. Gets the pass, but throws it away. Intended over there on the far sideline for number 30, Victor Henry. Incomplete will bring up a third down and 7.
Looks like number 48 for the Leathernecks, Western Illinois. Looks like he got a piece of that ball when Reggie threw that one to knock it out of bounds.
The nickelback, Brian Cox, up from his nickelback spot. He's sort of a rover back there, a kind of a half secondary player, half linebacker, as he goes with the strong side of the formation for Western Illinois. Now he will go to the right side. Now Lewis looking to throw. He's going to try to air it out for Victor Henry. And Henry will not have a chance to get the football. Battle over here on the near sideline with Bill Hunter. A little contact.
That's what I was just about to say, Rod. And number 4 looked like he was hanging on Victor Henry on that one. And no flag call on that one. That's surprising. That looked like a little bit of interference on that one, but no call. The Bearcats off of punting away now. Bart Bradley back for Sam Houston.
39, John McHugh along with the free safety, Maurice Smith, back in double safety for Western Illinois. Bart Bradley, the sophomore punter from Kilgore, Texas, on to punt. And he gets the line drive punt off. Maurice Smith fields it back at the 21. Now we'll cross the 25 to the 30 and will be tackled at about the 36-yard line. 43, Lysh Adams on the tackle for Sam Houston. A little help from 35, Roger Johnson, the middle linebacker. And Western Illinois will scrimmage now, first and 10. Lysh Adams and Chris Herman on the tackle. 11 minutes, 57 seconds to go. Third quarter of play. Bearcats leading at 21-10 over the Western Illinois Leathernecks. Paul Zinger comes out at quarterback. He will send number 10 out to the right side. That's Chris Earl. 80 Borich is wide to the right side. Split backs. As Singer back to throw, has to unload it quickly, skips it in, and that time the blitz coming from weak side linebacker Tolly Royal up to put pressure on Paul Singer.
And I think he did just that. Singer rushed his pass, bounced it in. Tolly Royal, good play on the defensive side for Sam Houston. Second down and 10 now for Western Illinois.
Don Beebe, the senior from Sugar Grove, Illinois, checks into the ball game for Western Illinois. Spot the ball at the 36-yard line. As Steve Williams goes wide to the left side, Don Beebe is wide to the right. Shotgun formation, first time we've seen that. Singer back in the pocket trying to get more time to throw. Now under a heavy rush, throws the ball up, and it is knocked down. Nice defensive play that time by Ricky Royal. And you know, Randy, early in the season, Ricky Royal had a habit of not looking back and going for the football. He had a lot of pass interference penalties. But in the last few weeks, Ricky Royal has played good defensive coverage. He had a play just like that against Stephen F. Austin last week where he knocked the ball away in good shape. And he is becoming a premier secondary player for Sam Houston.
He sure is. Good play by Ricky Royal. Good job of knocking that one down. Even long yardage on that one. Big gain, but no deal for Western Illinois.
Third down and 10. Ball is fumbled. Now Singer picks it up, and the ball is complete. First down, number 85. That's the tight end, Jeff Prentice, who has showed good hands here in this ball game. The senior from Montgomery, Illinois, gets the pass reception. It will be good for first down yardage. And once again, the Bearcats give up long yardage on the third and long play.
Singer had problems on the snap on that one. The ball coming loose, kind of had looked like it had grease on it or something. Finally got a hold of it, though. Good completion. First down and 10 for Western Illinois. Ball
Chris,
on the 48-yard line.
Chris Earl goes wide to the left side with Don Bibby wide to the right. Now play action. Zinger looking to air it out. He's going to go long. Meldon Mickles needs to turn around and look for the football. The ball is caught out of bounds at the 1 yard line. And that time, Meldon Mickles didn't know where the football was, didn't look back to the last moment. And Don Bibby, the senior from Sugar Grove, Illinois, comes up with a reception at the 1 yard line.
Bibby very upset with himself on that one. He caught it. And right when he looked down, he was already out of bounds at the one-inch line. He's about almost in there. His foot went out of bounds right before the marker by the goal line. First and inches for Western Illinois. They're about to close the gap now. 21-10 the score right now.
1 yard away from pay dirt. The backfield is Brett Grimshaw and 24 Claude Millsap. Straight up the middle. Paul Singer sneaks it into the end zone. He has the touchdown on the 1 yard run. So the Leathernecks close the gap here, 11:05 to go here in the third quarter. It's now 21-16 with the extra point attempt to come, and Western Illinois jumps out and gets momentum here in the second half.
That's something the Bearcats did not need to happen. Still a lot of time left here in the ball game. Melvin Mickles should have knocked that ball away when it was thrown down to Bibby at the goal line there. But
now Western Illinois lining up for the two-point conversion, trying to catch the Bearcats asleep. Singer will roll it out, looking to throw, has a man. It's complete. Two-point conversion, 24, Claude Millsap. And a big play, because that makes the deficit 2 points. And with 11:05 to go in the third quarter, your new score, Sam Houston 21, Western Illinois 18.
You say you've got too much to do and not enough time to do it. Are the pressures of school and your job getting too much for you to handle? And it's time for a stress watch. Join Cassandra Baker and her assistant Belinda Pineda for solutions to time management and helpful tips to handle stress only. On cable, Channel 7, that's Wednesday nights beginning at 9 p.m. The Leathernecks are back in this ballgame, Rod. 3 points down, 11:05 left. We've got a new ballgame here at Bearcat Stadium.
So the Bearcats will now go back on offense, barring any type of disaster on the kickoff. Need to establish a good scoring drive here in the second half as the Leathernecks take the ball and run it right down the throats of the Bearcats. Good. The big play that time, the long pass down to the 1 yard line from Paul Singer to Don Bibby. Number 17, Lane Bennett, the sophomore from Pittsfield, Illinois, has it teed up at the 35 yard line. Back deep, number 30, Victor Henry, along with 34, Ricky Davis, to return the kickoff for Sam Houston. Ricky Davis has it. Short kickoff will come across the 25. Now breaks a couple of tackles. Gets out across the 45. And a nice run that time by the backup tailback, Ricky Davis. He's only a freshman squadsman from Fort Worth Everman High School, but a flag is down.
Also, a Leatherneck is down, number 30, I believe. Number 30 for the Leathernecks, William Brazil, cornerback. He walked it off, though. He's limping off. But we got a penalty on the Bearcats, it looks like. Let's see what the call is.
Probably be an illegal block, as it is a clip against Sam Houston. So a return out across the 45 is spotted back at the 16. A big mistake on the Bearcats specialty teams, and they will scrimmage from poor field position deep in their own territory. Keith Willis is wide to the right side. Or wide to the left side with Victor Henry over on the far side. Turner and Shorts are the setbacks. Handed off straight up the middle. James Shorts will go for short yardage, perhaps 2 yards on the play.
Big, important series for Sam Houston on this one. If they get held up by Western Illinois, that's going to fire them up even more, because they're only 3 points down on the road, which is unusual, especially at Bearcat Stadium. So Bearcats needing some points badly. Even if it's a field goal, they need to get something on the board.
Reggie Lewis will roll it out. Now looking to throw the football. Has a man, overthrows the intended receiver, Ricky Eggleston. Ball is almost picked off by number 23 for Western Illinois. That's Mike Himley. So the Bearcat offense now starting to look sluggish is faced with a third down and eight situation. Keith Willis comes wide to the left side, but Victor Henry wide to the right. Now split backs behind Reggie Lewis, dropping straight back to throw. Looking to air it out, gets it to shorts. He will turn it upfield and will not have enough for the first down. He is going to be about a yard short and a punting situation for the Bearcats.
We need a good one out of Bart Bradley. He needs to get him back in their territory pretty deep if he can. Not a great day of punting so far for Bart Bradley, but he needs to break it right now.
39, John McHugh along with Maurice Smith back in double safety for Western Illinois. Bart Bradley back to punt for Sam Houston. Bradley gets the kick away. Low line drive will be taken by McHugh. He returns it and breaks a couple of tackles. Now will go across the 40-yard line. Nice tackle on the play for Sam Houston, 72. That's Chris Herman, an offensive tackle, up to make the stop for the Bearcats. So Paul Singer and the Western Illinois offense back out onto the field. Bearcats leading at 21-18, but momentum shifting in the second half as Mike Borish goes wide to the left side. And number 10, that's Chris Earl, is wide to the right. Singer looking to throw the football, has a man wide open. That's the fullback, Brett Grimshaw.
Grimshaw, a busy man this afternoon so far, several receptions. I'm not sure how many he had in the first half, but it was a good handful.
Grimshaw with three catches, 32 yards, his long being 17 in the first half. Pickup of 7 yards on that last pass play will bring up a second down and three as Steve Williams is wide to the left side and Don Bibby is wide to the right. I formation now, play action, Zinger looking to throw, avoids pressure, the ball goes in and out of the hands, 83 that time.
Tom Bragg, the tight end for Western Illinois, right through his hands. Two Bearcat defenders right there to pop him, but and catch the ball. Good break for Sam Houston. Third down and three now for Western Illinois. Big play for the defense of Sam Houston. They need to hold him right here. Stop this drive right now. Get the ball back.
Chris Earl wide to the left side with Mike Borich wide to the right. Split backs behind Paul Singer. Now straight back to throw. Looking to go. Hits his fullback once again. First down out across midfield. That's Brett Grimshaw, the junior from Burlington, Iowa, has the reception in the first down. And Paul Singer continues to brilliantly move this Western Illinois offense.
It's a simple play. The fullback just comes around in the secondary in about 10-yard pattern, and he's wide open every time. All afternoon he's been there.
Chris Earl, the junior from DeKalb, Illinois, is split wide to the left side. Hand the ball straight up the middle. Number 24, Claude Millsap, the senior from Plymouth, Florida, on the carry. He will have about 3 yards on the carry, bring up a second down and seven. Checking into the ball game is Mike Cox as Millsap goes to the near side bench. Second down and seven, ball at the 43-yard line in Bearcat territory. Now double wide receivers Steve Williams and number 80 Mike Borich are both split wide to the left side. Split backs behind Paul Singer. Movement in the offensive line, pass over the middle, complete, nice hit, but a nice catch. Mike Borich hit on the play and brought down by number 43, Lysh Adams. No flags are down. A first down for Western Illinois, and they continue to move the chains and move the football here in the second half.
Ball's going to be marked at the 31-yard line. Clock running, 8 minutes remaining here in the third quarter.
So Chris Earl goes wide to the left side with Don Bibby wide to the right. Flea flicker, now Singer looking to throw. Has a man trying to beat Nichols. Ball is caught, but out of the back of the end zone. Once again, Paul Singer did not look back for the football. Meldon Nichols didn't look back for the football, but fortunately for him, the ball was thrown out of the back of the end zone.
That one was almost caught inbounds. He had one foot in, I believe. It looked like it from here. Close play again. Meldon Nichols getting tested down there on the right side by Paul Singer.
So the Leathernecks are faced with a second down and 10 ball at the 31-yard line in Sam Houston territory. Now the draw play up the middle. Nice hit, nice open field tackle. 59, Andre Finley, who is having a great day from that strong side end position. The sophomore one-year letterman from Houston Forest Brook up to make the stop for Sam Houston.
Big play by the defense. Third down now for Western Illinois.
Third and 11, give him a loss of a yard on that play.
They hold him here. It'll be a long field goal attempt for Western Illinois.
Don Bibby goes wide to the left side with Chris Earl wide to the right. Straight back to throw is Singer. Now looking, has a man. Ball is almost caught. Nice defensive play. Lysh Adams, pass intended for Jeff Prentice. The tight end had it in his hands, but a nice pop from the junior linebacker from Jasper, Lysh Adams, from his strong side linebacking spot on the coverage. And it looks like Coach Bruce Craddock is going to go for it on fourth and 11. So a very big defensive play now here for Sam Houston, as Singer has had success against the Bearcats secondary. Will test him on fourth and 11, straight back to throw. Looking, has a man. Ball is complete, and it is going to be very, very close to the first down.
It doesn't look like they're going to have it from here. I don't think they're going to mark it. He needs to be just inside the 22-yard line. It's going to be very close, like you said. It's going to be within inches.
They are going to have to bring in the change from over on the far sideline. That time, a nice pass completed by Paul Singer. It's going to be very close. Stretch the chains, and not quite enough. Bearcat defense holds, and that could be a big momentum switch for Sam Houston as they hold on the fourth and 10 play. But Paul Singer nearly rescued the Leathernecks out of trouble as he completed the fourth and 10 pass, and it just ended inches short of the first down.
Bearcat very lucky on that one. They stopped him, but he was just inches short. Very important here for the offense to get something going here in the third quarter. Reggie Lewis needs to come out passing.
Willis wide to the left, Henry wide to the right. Play action now. Lewis looking to go long, has Willis. Ball will be overthrown. Coverage on the play by number four. That's Hunter on the coverage for Western Illinois. Bill Hunter along with Emmerich Wilcox, the left side cornerback, on the coverage. That time the pass was just overthrown.
Bill Hunter, a 5'10", 180-pound sophomore out of Macomb, Illinois. Carthage High School there. Good coverage on Keith Willis. Second down and 10 for Sam Houston.
Al Lopez is split wide to the left side, but Victor Henry wide to the right. Split backs behind the quarterback, Reggie Lewis. Now looking to swing it out. Has a man. That's Victor Henry. Has it go off his hands. And that time, Victor Henry could not come up with the pass reception. And the Bearcats now faced with third and 10 have found the offense hard to come by here in the second half.
Whatever Coach Bruce Craddock of Western Illinois told his team at halftime, it's working. The defense of Western Illinois improved very much so far through this third period. Bearcat offense doing absolutely nothing so far.
Third and 10, straight back to throw. Lewis with time. Ball is skipped into Eggleston. Bearcats will be forced to punt, and the Bearcats are going to have to make some adjustments offensively as they have not been able to move the ball here in the second half. Bart Bradley will come on to punt the ball for Sam Houston.
You can't keep giving these teams opportunities when they're on the road. If they're close, they're going to be fired up. They're going to be wanting to beat the tail out of you, and they're just not going to – you can't keep giving those opportunities to them. And the Bearcats are doing just that. They've got lucky on a couple of times so far.
Nice punt that time by Bradley will drive Smith back to his 25-yard line. Now has some blockers out in front. Will try to turn it upfield. Will go out of bounds. Hit on the play by Leish Adams. 38-yard line where Paul Singer and the Western Illinois offense once again takes over. And you know, Randy, that Bearcat defense is going to tire out if they stay on the field this long here in the second half.
Exactly right. They got to have that offense on the field, moving the ball, which is not happening so far in the third quarter. 21-18 the score if you're just joining us. 6:17 left here in the third period of play.
Don Bibby wide to the left side with Chris Earl wide to the right. Now pitch it back deep in the backfield. Cox has it. He will be stopped at the 40-yard line. Mike Cox, the sophomore from East St. Louis, will be brought down. Give him a gain of 2 yards or 2 yards on the play to bring up a second down and 8.
Number 2, Steve Williams, and number 80, Mike Boris, checks in for Western Illinois. Number 5, Don Bibby, split in, comes out.
Now Borich comes wide to the right side with Steve Williams wide to the left. Now shotgun formation, second down and 7 for Western Illinois. Singer looking to throw, now avoids pressure, gets it out. Man is open, but the pass is going to be out of bounds. 31 on the coverage for Sam Houston. That's Livingston. Charles Livingston, who has not seen a whole lot of playing time in the Bearcats secondary, in there now.
I just noticed the sideline rod, number 14, Brian Osterhaus, warming up over there, and I don't know what that means. Would you think Ron Randall would want to pull him in there, third quarter?
Well, if the offense isn't running well, he may decide to go with Brian Osterhaus. As we mentioned, Charles Livingston has checked in. Meldon Mickles is on the bench. Now out of the pocket, Singer looking to run the football. Will go out of bounds. He will not have enough for the first down. And we mentioned Meldon Mickles not looking good on a couple of those passes where he got beat. And now Coach Ron Randleman has inserted Charles Livingston into the defensive secondary. So Billy Anderson drops back in single safety as Mike Krause will be back to punt for Western Illinois. So the Bearcat defense holding, looking for a chance to get some offensive momentum going here in the second half. They have not been able to move the ball offensively. Billy Anderson will let this one go, and it will die at the 5-yard line. Once again, Western Illinois will put the Bearcats in very poor field position. With 5 minutes, 7 seconds to go here in the third quarter, it's Sam Houston 21, Western Illinois 18.
Community events, special services, and general information of interest to the Huntsville area are just some of the topics discussed on 15 Minutes on Cable Channel 7, Monday through Thursdays at 10 p.m. The Bearcat offense ready to roll here, 5-yard line. They need some points very quickly, 5:07 remaining here in the third period.
Henry wide to the left, Willis wide to the right, now play action. Reggie Lewis looking for Eggleston once again, under throws his tight end. Defensive coverage on the play, number 3 for Western Illinois. That's Lorenzo Taylor, the strong safety sophomore from East St. Louis. But that time, once again, the pass by Reggie Lewis underthrown to the tight end, Ricky Eggleston. Now Lopez goes wide to the left side with Keith Willis wide to the right. I formation now behind the quarterback, Reggie Lewis. Second and 10, now he drops back in his own end zone, looking to air it out, has a man, that's Willis, complete. He will have first down yardage over the 20-yard line, out to the 23, and that time Reggie Lewis threads the needle and gets it to his old high school teammate, Keith Willis.
Big completion right there for Reggie Lewis to Keith Willis. That'll be a first down now for Sam Houston. They had to get out of that hole there at the 5-yard line. Dangerous, very dangerous down there when you're by your own end zone, so. A little bit of breathing room now for the Bearcat offense.
First and 10, ball at the 23-yard line. hand the ball straight up the middle to Luther Turner, who hasn't had too much going his way here this afternoon. Rushing-wise, Turner, with only 28 yards in the first half, hasn't netted too many more yards to that total here in the second half. But a good gain that time is he got about 6, maybe 7 yards. Give him a gain of 6 and bring up a second down and 4. Lopez goes wide to the right side. Victor Henry is wide to the near side. I formation. Reggie Lewis will pitch it in the backfield now. Turner looking to turn it upfield. Runs over a couple of defenders and gets the first down. Number 15, the free safety, Maurice Smith, up to make the tackle along with number 4, Bill Hunter, the right side cornerback. But it'll be good enough for a Sam Houston first down.
Cool. 3:50 remaining here in the third period.
Keith Willis wide to the left side. Victor Henry wide to the right. Ricky Eggleston is the tight end of the right side I formation. Now Lewis roll it out. Now looking to run with the football. Avoids a couple of tacklers. Dives. He will have about 9 yards. He will be about a yard short of the first down. And the Bearcat offense starting to show some signs of life here late in the third quarter.
They put a good move right there on Marlon Williams, the defensive end, number 99 for Western Illinois. Williams right there. Lewis cut back in, gained about an extra 5 yards on that one. Good run by Reggie Lewis. Second down and 9. Sam Houston now.
Lopez is wide to the left side. Keith Willis wide to the right. Now under 3 minutes to go, third quarter of play. Bearcats leading it over Western Illinois, 21-18. Pitch it deep in the backfield. Luther Turner looking for a block. Will not find easy going that time. Tackle on the play. Number 79, Pat Sullivan, the junior from Polo, Missouri, up from his right tackle spot to make the tackle for Western Illinois. Thad Trumps checks into the ballgame at a linebacker for Western Illinois. Now Reggie Lewis, not liking what he sees, will have to call a timeout. First one taken by Sam Houston here in the second half. So with 2 minutes, 25 seconds to go, third quarter of play from Bearcat Stadium in Huntsville. It's the Bearcats 21, Western Illinois 18.
Find out why over 5,000 young men and women have pledged fraternities and sororities at Sam Houston State University. Join host Chris Bianco for a look at fraternities on cable channel 7 Monday nights at 9:30. And the madcap adventures of Alan Roten and Nigel down in their little corner of the world known as Wits End. That's on this fall, cable channel 7 Monday nights at 8 p.m. Join it. It's not a bad show. I've caught it one time, Rod. It's not too bad.
Some real good dramatic action in that show. As the Bearcats now looking to mount some offense here in the second half. As they find themselves faced with a first and 10 with the ball spotted at the 46-yard line. The Bearcats looking for a Division I AA playoff berth here this afternoon. They need to win their last two ball games. Don't forget, next week the Bearcats will be in action at San Marcos against Southwest Texas State. Hand the ball straight up the middle. James Shorts breaks a couple of tackles. Good yardage. Nice shoestring tackle by Bill Hunter. What a nice run that time by the junior from right here in Huntsville, Texas. James Shorts gets up limping, but he has good yardage for the first down.
He broke a tackle on that, gained about an extra 5 to 7 yards. Good run by James Shorts. Bearcats now in Western Illinois territory for the first time in the second half.
Split backs is James Lopez is wide to the left side, Victor Henry wide to the right. Shorts and Turner, the setbacks behind Reggie Lewis, dropping straight to throw, looking quickly for Lopez. Lopez has it, goes out of bounds at about the 32-yard line, close to the 31. He's going to be about 2 yards, maybe 3 yards short of the first down. So Sam Houston will be faced with a second down and 3.
2.
Second down and 2 now for Reggie Lewis in the offense. Need a first down.
Willis wide to the left side with Henry wide right. Now Lewis looking to throw, tries to air it out. That ball is complete to Eggleston. Takes a shot by the free safety, Maurice Smith. Puts the hit on Eggleston, but Eggleston has the ball complete, and to me it looked like he was going for Victor Henry over there on the far sideline. I was about to say that pass is poorly underthrown, and
exactly.
Here comes Ricky Eggleston out of nowhere to nab it.
I did not see Eggleston in the corner of my eye at all. I thought that was a definite interception for Western Illinois, but there comes Ricky Eggleston once again. Big catch for Sam Houston, first and 10, 19-yard line of Western Illinois.
One wide receiver now. Bearcats go with the double tight end set, looking to run it with Turner. Turner inside the 15, down to about the 10-yard line. Gain. And a flag is down. And I think we're going to have a penalty for unnecessary roughness on one of the Leathernecks as the flag came late from the side judge. And now the Leatherneck players are saying that it's against Sam Houston. We haven't got an indication, but it looked like they were going to throw a sportsman or unsportsmanlike conduct penalty against Western Illinois. Personal foul will go against Sam Houston.
We'll push it back 15 yards now.
I really didn't see what happened that time on the play, but apparently some kind of scuffle broke out in the secondary. They flag and a big penalty against Sam Houston. Moves the ball back to the 26-yard line. Second down and 18, and that penalty is a killer. Henry is the lone wide receiver to the left side. Reggie Lewis drops straight back to throw, looking for Eggleston, has it. Inside the 15, Maurice Smith makes the tackle. But Ricky Eggleston has the pass completion. Down to about the 12-yard line will put him about 4 yards, maybe 3 yards short of the first down. And Ricky Eggleston is getting some good quality work in here today at Bearcat Stadium.
He got hit hard once again, number 15 on the tackle. Maurice Smith, good hit, but Bearcats now in good shape, 3rd down and 4.
Big play for the Bearcats, 3rd down and 4. Pitch it deep in the backfield to Turner. Turner looking to turn it upfield, breaks a couple of tackles and gets inside the 5-yard line. 1st and 10, Sam Houston.
Luther Turner with some touchdowns last week. They established a new school record, 16 touchdowns on the season now. For Luther Turner, he's about to score another one.
Perhaps as Reggie Lewis has thrown 3 touchdown passes and has accounted for all of the points, as the Bearcats will call a timeout has been taken by Western Illinois. So with 18 seconds to go in the third quarter, Bearcats leading it over Western Illinois 21-18. But the Bearcats only 4 yards away from pay dirt, looking to put themselves back in the driver's seat in this football game.
Coming this fall on cable channel 7, In Their Time, a show featuring 6 great Americans who have influenced our country in the post-World War II era. Host Mike Nagy interviews noted scholars on the impact of these Americans. That's Wednesday nights at 7:30 right here on cable channel 7. 1st and 5 now for Sam Houston. Pick that, make it 1st and goal. No opportunity for a first down. They need to get it in now. 18 seconds left here in the third period.
So a very important series of downs right here for Sam Houston. With only 18 seconds, the Bearcats really need to go up by more than a touchdown, because as we saw in the first half with the 64-yard touchdown pass from Paul Singer to his wide receiver Mike Borich, the Western Illinois Leathernecks can strike quickly. Now the Bearcats trying to run a quick play. 1st and goal from the 4. Pitch it deep in the backfield. Luther Turner looking for number 17. Will get close. He will be down to about the 2-yard line. So that's going to be the last play here in the third quarter, as the Bearcats will, if they're going to punch it in, will have to do it down at the other end of the field. As we have 15 minutes to go in this football game, designated Southland Conference game, for Sam Houston. It's 21-18. Now, the Bearcats will not run this play. We have come to the end of the third quarter with the Bearcats leading it 21-18.
Guys, are you tired of cafeteria food? Do you want to impress your girlfriend? And join host Kevin Davis, who will show you how to prepare tasty cuisine on Bachelor Chef right here on Cable Channel 7 Wednesday nights at 8 p.m. And Variety Showcase will be on this fall on Cable Channel 7. It's the show that glistens with local entertainers. That's Variety Showcase only on Cable Channel 7 Wednesday nights following Bachelor Chef at 8:30 p.m.
So we've come to the final 15 minutes of this football game. Bearcats looking to extend their lead to 10 points over Western Illinois. A very important game as the Leathernecks came into today's game ranked number 19 in Division I-AA. The Bearcats ranked number 20. Bearcats looking to move up in that ranking and perhaps get themselves in a position to earn an at-large playoff spot next week when they travel to San Marcos, Texas to take on the Bobcats of Southwest Texas State. Tim Rome into the ball game. He will be the lone wide receiver out to the left side. Splitbacks Turner and James Shorts behind Reggie Lewis. Tight end set on both sides. Turner up the middle. He is going to be short of the goal line. It's going to be about a foot short. That play never really developed too well.
Third down now for Sam Houston.
Third down, ball about a yard away from the goal line. Victor Henry is the lone wide receiver. He's out to the left side. Tight end set to the left is Rob Beecham. Tight end to the right is Ricky Eggleston. Tailback is Luther Turner in front behind Shorts. Now handed to Turner, puts the head down and gets into the end zone for the touchdown. Luther Turner with his 17th touchdown of the year, and the Bearcats are back up by 9 with the extra point attempt to come.
Western Illinois players arguing with the referee. They thought Luther Turner hit the ground before the goal line, but no deal on that one. We'll take it. Luther Turner, another touchdown, number 17 on the year. Big play, big series for the Bearcats. Gives them a little bit of room now. 27-18 the score. For the Hayes, about to knock in the extra point here.
Out of the hold of Bart Bradley. Extra point attempt is up and good. Billy Hayes, the junior from LaPorte, has not missed an extra point this season. And with 14 minutes, 20 seconds to go in this football game, your new score, Sam Houston State 28, Western Illinois 18.
Plan to watch Cable Channel 7 for local entertainment, information, and news. If you look for the new fitness series coming this fall, well, actually it's going on right now, Get in Shape. It's a health magazine for the fit and the not so fit. There'll be many topics such as running, biking, general fitness, and others. Each show will offer aerobics and a segment of exercise for the handicapped and elderly. Join us this fall on Cable Channel 7. Come on, Huntsville, get in shape. That's Mondays at 7 p.m. right here on Cable Channel 7.
So with 14 minutes, 20 seconds to go in this football game, the Bearcats, now up by 10, need to play some defense, contain that Western Illinois explosive offense, because they need to come away with the victory here today, and that would mean the second consecutive season, Randy, that they have not lost a home game in Bearcat Stadium. A very impressive feat. So Jerome Heim, the senior place kicker, two-year letterman from Houston Klein Forest, has the ball teed up at the 35-yard line. Back deep for Western Illinois is number 30. That's William Brazil. The kickoff will come to Brazil. He will be across the 20-yard line. He will be corralled at about the 26, and that's where Paul Singer and the Western Illinois offense will operate first and 10.
Big series right here for the defense. It looks, seems like I've been saying that all afternoon, but right now they need to stop Western Illinois from scoring here in the fourth quarter. Don't let them get any momentum. That's the last thing we want them to get. 28-18 to score. Keep the lead difference at a high score. They're up by 10 right now. We need to keep it that way.
Pass complete over the middle to Tom Bragg, the tight end. He has good yardage, about 8 yards on the play. Bring up a second down and two for Western Illinois. And the quarterback, Paul Singer, continues to find holes in the Bearcats secondary. Now Don Bibby is wide to the left side with Earl wide to the right. Now looking to throw. Has a man. That's Steve Williams, complete out near midfield. First and 10 for Western Illinois. Clock runs with 13:30 to go in the football game. This one could come down to the final minutes if Western Illinois continues to move the ball. Mike Borich split wide to the left side. Up at the top of the picture is Chris Earl. Now straight drop to throw a zinger, looking deep, has a man over the middle. That's Earl. He is hit by Charles Livingston at the 30, but about a 22-yard pickup on the play, and Paul Singer continues to mount large chunks of yardage here in the second half for Western Illinois.
Number 31, Charles Livingston for the Bearcats, 5'11", 200-pound, one-year letterman, at sophomore out of Houston Forest Brook. Seems like a lot of room has been in that secondary this second half. Paul Singer finding his receivers, a lot of room in the secondary.
Now Singer straight back to throw, looking across the middle, has pressure, wings it out, and it is incomplete, intended over here on the near sideline for number 5, Don Bibby. Coverage on the play by 26, Ricky Royal, and number 40, Lloyd Powell. That time, good pressure up the middle forced Paul Singer to get rid of the football before he wanted to throw it.
Good pressure by the defensive line of Sam Houston. Taking down now for Western Illinois. Big series for the defense. They need to hold them.
Chris Earl comes wide to the left side with Mike Borich split wide to the right. Split backs behind the quarterback, Paul Singer, on second down and 10. Looking to air it out. Has a man. The ball is picked off. It's intercepted. Now it is fumbled. Picked back up by Ricky Royal. And he is going, let's see what they're going to rule. It should be Bearcat football because Royal had control of the football. Then he fumbled the football.
Bruce Craddock not happy with that call. He's going on the field. He's not happy at all. It could really go either way. Look, didn't look like he had that much possession to me. He was bobbling it before he dropped it. But they call it for Sam Houston. We'll take it.
Then they spot it back at the 30-yard line.
Now, I don't understand why they're doing that. They're spotting it where Ricky Royal dropped the ball. Now, if they say he caught it, if he dropped it, he should pick it right back up and keep it.
Because he recovered the fumble. You can't advance your own fumble. That's only in the last 2 minutes of the game. And he was the one that fumbled it. So he can recover it anyway. So not really understanding that call. But anyway, Reggie Lewis looking for yardage. And the ball, I believe, hit the referee or came closer, went off one of the helmets of one of the players. And the ball falls incomplete. Intended for Rob Beecham. So a big play, maybe a game saver for Sam Houston as Ricky Royal picks off the pass and then fumbles it. I thought he had control of the football because, heck, he returned it. You know, he had 3 or 4 good steps before he fumbled the football, so it looked like he clearly had possession of the ball. I really don't understand why they did not mark the ball where he recovered and went out of bounds.
That's what I was wondering, the same thing. That just doesn't make sense.
Anyway, 2nd and 10, Reggie Lewis looking to get the ball out to Victor Henry. Oh. And will not be able to do it. 3rd down and 10. The pressure forcing Reggie Lewis to get rid of the football before he wanted to. Now 3rd down and 10. The Bearcats need to pick up yardage and run some of the time off this clock. As the clock shows 12 minutes, 19 seconds, it stopped. Bearcats up 28-18. Victor Henry wide to the left side. James Lopez wide to the right. Split back. Shorts and Turner. behind Reggie Lewis. Third down and 10. Ball at the 29. Lewis running the option, turns it upfield, and will be close to the first down.
See where they mark it. They're going to mark it right at the first.
He got it. I believe he got it just over the 39. He had to get right to the 39 to pick up the first down.
They're going to bring out the flags to make sure of that. It's going to be a close one.
Reggie Lewis showed good ability that time as he turned up the option play inside and dove for what appears to be first down yardage. Now the chain gang will bring him in from across the way and stretch him out. Number 90 shaking up for Western Illinois. That's Rick Renner, the defensive tackle.
First down and 10 for Sam Houston. They got it by about a foot.
So a big play as that makes the that gives the Bearcats another set of downs to work with and keeps the clock running as they will start the clock as the chains are set. Now the clock runs with 12:06 to go. Fourth and final quarter from Bearcat Stadium in Huntsville, the final home game of the 1987 season. Bearcats leading it 28-18. Henry wide to the left side, Willis wide to the right. Reggie Lewis will hand the ball off. Luther Turner, he's into the secondary. Watch him go. He's across the 30. Nobody's going to catch Luther Turner. He goes into the end zone. 18th touchdown of the year, and the Bearcats are now comfortably in front here at Bearcat Stadium.
He busted that one up the middle, broke a tackle, and he's gone. There's no way anybody was going to catch him on that. Nice run by Luther Turner. Reggie Lewis wrecking that offense once again. Luther Turner, touchdown number 18 for 1987. And still a game to go. We still have Southwest Texas. He will break that record by a lot. Anybody who breaks that one from now on will have to have a great season.
Unofficially, I give him 61 yards on the touchdown run.
That sounds good to me from the 39.
Extra point attempt is up, and it is good. So the 18th touchdown of the year for Luther Turner, I believe, isn't the Southland Conference record is 19.
We are correct on that one, and he has a chance to break that. Do a little research here and find out what the record is.
That's 19 by Buford McGee of McNeese State, I believe, has 19. We'll make sure. I know that the record is 19 because Luther Turner was just a few touchdowns short. He said he was going to try to go for it. Now the Bearcats on top.
.11:44 remaining here in the fourth quarter. And you can just about guarantee Paul Singer will come out throwing for the rest of the game. They need points. They need points quickly.
So 35-18, Bearcats leading it.
Sure, I'm glad I'm not a cheerleader, Rod. Look at all this push-up they're doing out there.
35 points as the Bearcats are once again mounting up offense and scoring, as once again they score over 30 points. Only one game this season that they didn't do that. That was North Texas State. Now Cox on the return will be buried across the 25-yard line. Nice tackle on the play off the bottom of the pile for Sam Houston. 34, Ricky Davis makes the stop on number 20, Mike Cox. And the Western Illinois offense will go to work, first and 10. A brilliant run that time by Luther Turner. So you can bet Paul Singer is going to let it fly. Now he will come out with four wide receivers, all of his wide receivers. As number 5, Don Bibby goes in motion, looking to the right side. Singer has all kinds of time, will complete the pass out to Steve Williams. And the ball is fumbled. Off the bottom of the pile, they're going to say he was down as the whistle blew. So 11:17, clock runs. A gain of 7 yards on that play will bring up a second down and 3.
Best thing for the Bearcat defense to do, keep them in bounds. The offense of Western Illinois, get that clock running. The more time is eaten up, the better the chances are for Sam Houston. Comfortable lead, though, right now, 35-18. Paul Singer trying to get something going with the offense for the Leathernecks.
He will hand the ball off to the tailback. That's 28, Brett Grimshaw. The junior from Burlington, Iowa, carries up close to first down yardage. He will be short, but more importantly for the Bearcats, the clock continues to run now with 10 minutes and 37 seconds
left in the ball game. Don Beebe in for Western Illinois, split in. Mike Borich out for Western Illinois, flanker. Second, third down and one now for Western Illinois. Ball on the 36-yard line.
82 checks into the ball game for Western Illinois. That's Wes Currier, a flanker, as they will go with four wide receivers and hand the ball straight up the middle to the tail or take it the fullback. That's 28, Brett Grimshaw, who's working from the single back position. Looks kind of like a conservative game plan here by Coach Bruce Craddock with only 10 minutes to go in the football game, and he is running the football down by over two touchdowns. Two wide receivers, that's Chris Earl and Beebe, both wide to the left side. Now Borich comes in motion. Ball is caught over the middle by Borich. Tackled on the play, Lloyd Powell, with help from Tolly Royal. It will be good enough, or check it on the first down play, will gain about 7 yards. Now the hurry up offense for Western Illinois. As 85 checks into the ball game, that's Jeff Prentice, the tight end. Now the Bearcats all dropping off in coverage. Singer looking, ball is picked off. Billy Anderson once again returns up the field. Singer, the only one who has a chance to catch him. Billy Anderson's got it, touchdown.
Billy Anderson, interception number 6 on the season. And folks, he's only been back there, this is his 4th game. He is leading the Southland Conference in interceptions in 1987. His first return for a touchdown this year.
That interception return was in excess of 60 yards for Billy Anderson. He got it at about the 30, so close to 70 yards on the interception return. He got through the middle of that line, and Billy Anderson turned on the turbos and took it in for the touchdown. Extra point attempt is up and good, and this one is turned into a Bearcat rally as the Bearcats are now in front of Western Illinois, 42-18. The defense has turned the tide with a couple of interceptions here in the second half.
And Rod, I have one thing to say to you. If the selection committee for the NCAA does not want an explosive offense that the Bearcats have, they've got something wrong with them. This is a entertaining team for sure. Lots of points scored every week. Top players. We have probably one of the top quarterbacks in the state, if not the nation, Reggie Lewis.
And what about Billy Anderson? He's catching as many passes in the defensive secondary as he did when he played flanker. That's six interceptions on the season for Billy Anderson, and he's only been back there about 3 games. Unbelievable, as he has rose to the occasion for Coach Ron Randleman.
Talking about being at the right place at the right time, Billy Anderson has been there the last 4 weeks of play. 42-18, the score. The Bearcats are turning this one into a blowout. 9 minutes still left in the ball game.
Boy, I bet our friends in the Illinois area won't be too happy when they receive this tape, I'm telling you. But we'll be happy to send it to him. I think I'll send it by express mail. I told Whitey I'd get him that tape in a hurry. So
it's not something you want to show the kids and family when you go home.
No, not if you're from that area, let me tell you. Ball bounces, will be returned, fumbled, and clobbered on the far sideline by Charles Livingston.
Somebody popped him down there. The ball came loose. I don't know. It looks like Western Illinois recovered it once again. Almost another big break for the Bearcats. They almost recovered that one at the at the three, at the, make that the four-yard line.
At the five-yard line, Western Illinois takes over, and the wheels are coming off the apple cart here for Western Illinois in the fourth quarter. As I think Paul Singer has called it a day, he is going to go sit down and watch the final 8 minutes 59 seconds from a comfortable spot on the near sideline as number 14, that's Rick Fongstock, is checked into the game at quarterback. The handoff will go up the middle. 24 on the carry, that's Claude Millsap. He will go for short yardage, maybe only 1 yard.
Bearcats setting themselves up perfectly now. Northeast and Northeastern Louisiana, North Texas play this evening also. We're needing a Northeastern win over North Texas. Northeastern then plays Arkansas State next week, Rod. And that's a
designated Southland.
Yes, and Arkansas State, an excellent team. They beat North Texas a couple of weeks ago. They knock off Northeastern also. We'll have a three-way tie for first place.
Nothing could be sweeter if you're a Bearcat fan. That last pass complete to Tom Bragg, the tight end, but the clock continues to run. Third down and three. As Rick Fongstock operates at quarterback for Western Illinois. Fongstock looking to throw, has a man, ball is knocked away. Lloyd Powell, the senior from Somerville, up to put a little pop on number 28, Brett Grimshaw, and the ball falls incomplete, fourth down, and the punting unit checks it in for Western Illinois. Back to punt for Western Illinois, Mike Krause, a sophomore from Kewaunee, Illinois. Back deep to receive the punt for Sam Houston is Billy Anderson. Let's see if he will return it. He will across the 40, and he will be brought down at the 42. So good field position for Sam Houston. Yard punt that time by Mike Krause. Let's see, we may have some changes now for Sam Houston. As number 17, Bart Bradley has checked in at quarterback for Sam Houston.
I'm surprised Brian Osterhaus sit in there. It seems like he would want to get a few more snaps, possibly for an injury of Reggie Lewis next week.
Ball is fumbled on the handoff to Ricky Davis. Fortunately for Sam Houston, it was recovered. Wholesale changes now. Bart Bradley, the sophomore punter, has now checked in at quarterback for Sam Houston. He will have as his setbacks number 41. Bubba Shaw is the fullback. Ricky Davis is the tailback. As the handoff will go, Ricky Davis breaks it up the middle, and watch him go. Ricky Davis, the freshman from Fort Worth, Everman. And I tell you what, that freshman is going to be a mainstay in this Sam Houston running attack in the years to come.
He is. It's nice to see him get some experience this year, especially when the Bearcats are losing a few of those guys next year like Luther Turner. Ricky Davis getting some valuable experience. Nice run on that last play.
Tyrone Robinson is split wide to the left side with Tim Rohn wide to the right. Setbacks Shaw and Davis. First and 10, clock runs with 6:34 to play. Ricky Davis will be brought down in the backfield. Number 90 for Western Illinois up to make the tackle. That's Rick Renner, the left tackle senior from Geneva, Illinois. But right now the Bearcats just looking to keep that clock running and get out of here with a big victory here on the final day of the home season. And for the second year in a row, how sweet it is, the Bearcats will not lose at home at Bearcat Stadium.
That's a nice thing to hear right there. A good recruiting tool also. Home tradition, home winning tradition. That's nice to hear. Bearcats now.
Bart Bradley looking to throw, has Rob Beecham, and he fumbles the football, and it will go as incomplete. And right now, you got to really feel sorry for Bart Bradley. because I believe that's probably his first pass he's ever thrown as a Bearcat quarterback, and he got that one in good shape to Rob Beecham, who just couldn't hang on to the football.
Tim Rome checks in for Sam Houston. Number five, Tyrone Robinson checks out.
You know, you were talking about that mystique of Bearcat Stadium. Let's hope that in the years to come that tradition will help to bring bigger crowds out to Bearcat Stadium, as we did not have a very big crowd today. Pass is complete. Ricky Davis looking for somewhere to go, grabbed by the face mask. I don't see a penalty flag. It looked like Davis almost had his head ripped off on that one. It's going to be fourth down for Sam Houston. Spot the ball at the 29-yard line. I don't think that the Coach Ron Redman will send his field goal unit on with the big lead. So I guess he's going to go with this offense, this backup offense, and let him try to get the first down. Bart Bradley back to throw, looking up the middle, now being chased and will be sacked. Number 79 up for Western Illinois. That's Pat Sullivan, the junior from Polo, Missouri, up from his right tackle spot. The ball goes over on downs, but a good series. There's a lot of new faces got to see a little playing time, and not too bad of a job. They ran some time off the clock. 5 minutes, 4 seconds to go in this football game. The Bearcats comfortably in front, 42-18.
Rick Vonstock still in for Western Illinois. Shotgun formation.
Looking to throw, Fonstock has a man. Ball is picked off. Malcolm Royal across midfield, and Malcolm Royal gets one, and the Bearcat defensive secondary is having a field day here at Bearcat Stadium.
First one out to greet Royal was his brother Ricky Royal. Number 26 came out to greet him. Interception. Bart Bradley in the offense back out there for Sam Houston.
So Malcolm Royal up with the interception. And as you mentioned, right back onto the field is that Sam Houston offense looking to run a little time off the clock. Davis and Bubba Shaw are the setbacks. Tim Roan goes wide to the left side. Tyrone Robinson is wide to the right. Bart Bradley now talking, maybe audibilizing, as the clock runs down to 2 minutes and he will call a timeout, as I don't think Bart Bradley knew what was going on that series. We'll go over to talk it over with Coach Ron Randleman. With 4 minutes, 55 seconds to go in this football game, Bearcats leading it 42-18.
This fall, find out about the black community and its leaders. Huntsville's most prominent black men will be featured as they tell what they're doing to improve the quality of life in the black Huntsville community on Huntsville Elite each week on cable channel 7, Mondays at 9 p.m. And also beginning this fall, tune in for Artworks with your host, Kevin Davis. Kevin will be demonstrating basic drawing techniques and perspectives for young and old. Don't miss it. Artworks right here on cable channel 7, 9:30 on Wednesday nights.
So 4 minutes, 55 seconds to go in the game. Rod Sydlik along with Randy McIlvoy from Bearcat Stadium here as the Bearcats have one well in command. 42-18, they lead it. Bart Bradley back to throw, rolling it out, looking, has a man. The ball is picked off. That's Maurice Smith, the free safety. Now he's got running room and will be dragged down by Ricky Davis down at the 15-yard line. Now a flag is down on the field as two of the Western Illinois players are standing over one of the linemen. I believe it's 57, David Elam, but a big interception that time by Bart Bradley.
A little bit of inexperience on that one on Bradley's part. He kind of forced that one. He was rolling to his left. That's a tough pass to make when you're rolling left and you're right-handed. But anyhow, the Western Illinois club has the ball again.
A late flag. It's not going to affect the interception. It will be Western Illinois football. Four minutes, 37 seconds to go. As the referees will sort this one out in the middle of the field.
Mm-hmm.
they haven't come up with a decision. We'd like to take this time to remind you that next week the Bearcats travel to San Marcos, Texas for their final game of the season as they take on the Bobcats of Southwest Texas State University. So if you got time next week and make the road trip down, Bearcats need your support in Bobcat country as they hope to bring Sam Houston another Division I-AA playoff berth.
Are you aware when the selection committee will pick those teams? Is there a set date for that?
Well, it will be after the conclusion of the season, so it will be sometime either Tuesday or Wednesday, I believe, when we'll get the announcement from the league office following the final week of the season. So we should know before Thanksgiving whether the Bearcats will be going to the playoffs. But still a big game as Bobcat Stadium, a tough place for anyone to play. The Bearcats will be there next weekend, 2 o'clock game next Saturday. Now the ball is fumbled by the quarterback, Funstock, and he will be down, lose yardage, about 6 yards he'll lose on the play. Clock continues to run now, 4 minutes, 27 seconds to go. So 42-18, Sam Houston leads it. Number two for Western Illinois. That's Steve Williams, wide to the left side. Shotgun formation. Fonstock looking to air it out. Now has pressure, tries to dump it off, has it to Cox. Cox will be brought down by number 40, Lloyd Powell. They'll bring up a third down and about 12 yards to pick up the first down for Western Illinois. So the clock continues to run, 3 minutes, 35 seconds. Very impressive game this afternoon. The defense rising to the occasion, picking off some Paul Zinger passes in the second half. And that has made the difference here in this football game, as that one's going to be picked off by Tolly Royal. Tolly Royal returns across the 30-yard line, and he is looking for somewhere to go. Will be corralled down at about the 45-yard line. And I believe that's about 5 interceptions on the day for Sam Houston.
Bearcat defenders playing exactly where the ball is this afternoon. Billy Anderson with an interception. Ricky Royal with an interception. Tyler Royal with another interception. So the Bearcat defense doing a good job. They're going to run this one out, I believe. 3:12 remaining.
Yeah, don't look for much more than a running game right up the middle. Conservative, hold on to the football and take it to the house. The game plan now for Sam Houston. Pitch it deep in the backfield. Ricky Davis will be corralled and dropped in the backfield. Open field tackle on the play by 46 for Western Illinois. That's Thad Trump up from his linebacking spot, and Western Illinois will take a timeout with 2 minutes and 58 seconds to go in the football game.
Coming this fall on Cable Channel 7, Aerobics for the Health of It, the new aerobics show for couples. You and a friend can enjoy the privacy of doing aerobics in your own home. That's on Cable Channel 7 this fall at 9 o'clock Thursday morning, so catch it on Cable Channel 7. 2:58 left. Another one here at Huntsville this morning. Start your day off on Cable Channel 7 with the all-new Huntsville this morning. 8:30 to 9:30 a.m. Monday through Thursday. Catch up on the current events of the community with Channel 7's morning television program, Huntsville This Morning. That's Monday through Thursday at 8:30 a.m.
We were talking about Luther Turner as he set a Sam Houston record for 16 touchdowns. He has 2 on the day today, so that gives him 18. Now he is now tied the Southland Conference record of 18, which was set by McNeese State's Buford Jordan in 1981. So one more touchdown on the season, and Luther Turner writes his name in the Southland Conference record book. But right now it's Ricky Davis across midfield.
Ricky Davis, Thad Trump on the tackle, 5 yard gain for the 15.
5 yard gain for Davis will bring up a third down and 4 situation. as Tim Roan checks into the ballgame at a wide receiver spot. We'll bring in the play to Bart Bradley. Clock continues to run, 2 minutes, 25 seconds to go in the ball game. Bradley pitches it deep in the backfield to Ricky Davis, turns it upfield. He will be about 2 yards short of the first down. Now the punt unit will come on for Sam Houston. As we're now under 2 minutes to go in the ball game. Back deep, dropping off in deep safety for Western Illinois is number 39. That's John McHugh, a cornerback, along with number 15, Maurice Smith, as Bart Bradley will probably get pressure on this punt attempt. Bradley gets off a boomer as a scuffle breaks out in the middle of the line. And whistles have blown. May have had a false start somewhere in the interior of the offensive line for Sam Houston. No penalty, the referees have just stopped play.
I'm not sure what the holdup here is on this one.
So the Bearcats looking to try and get an opportunity here to punt the football away. They were waiting to reset the clock, but there's only a minute 34 seconds to go in the ball game. Bart Bradley back to punt. Bradley gets off a line drive punt. It will be taken at the 10-yard line, and he will be corralled up to catch the punt, number 39. That's John McHugh. A minute 26 seconds to go in the ball game now. Western Illinois, one more crack possibly with the football. As now wholesale changes on defense, as Malcolm Roy is checked in at free safety, Jimmy Caldwell is checked in at cornerback. New quarterback for Western Illinois is going to be number 12. That's Ron Reed, who is checked in. Reed is a freshman from Crawfordville, Indiana, a freshman at quarterback. As 24 got the last carry for Western Illinois, that's Claude Millsap. And now the pass comes over here on the near sideline to Chris Earl. It will be complete and out of bounds.
Jimmy Caldwell on the tackle.
Jimmy Caldwell up from his cornerback spot to make the tackle for Sam Houston. So only 58 seconds to go, clock stopped.
Remember, we'll be in San Marcos next Saturday when the Bearcats finish up their 1987 season against Southwest Texas. And it looks like we're going to need another win next week to make sure we hit that playoff berth.
37 for Sam Houston. That's Reginald Oaks is into the ball game now at one defensive end, along with 58, Brandon Sandifer at linebacker. 63 also in the ball game, Kelly Oates, a defensive tackle. Todd Jones also in as the running back is corralled in the backfield. Todd Jones from his defensive tackle spot will bring down number 39, or check it, 35, or 39, John McHugh. So 37 seconds to go. Reed looking to throw, has a man, ball is complete, tackled by Brandon Sandifer. Pass is complete to number 83. That's Tom Bragg, the tight end. Clock runs 25 seconds to go in the game.
They're doing all they can to finish this one up on a positive note, if you can call it that.
Ball is overthrown by Reed. Steve Williams, the intended receiver, over here on the near sideline. Coverage by Charles Livingston and Donnie Boltauser. So 15 seconds to go in the ball game. Randy, an impressive game in the second half. The Bearcats come out and get the interception to turn the ball game around, and that was probably the story in the game. Paul Singer suffered interceptions last week that cost him. Same thing happened here at Bearcat Stadium today.
Almost another interception that time by number 25, Malcolm Royal.
83, the pass was intended for, and there's only 8 seconds to go, so this one in all is going to be over, and probably another snap and a fall on the football by Sam Houston. Your assessment of what took place this afternoon?
Well, the defense got it going again. They've been impressed the last 4 weeks. They do it again today when they needed to. These have all been must-win games, and they've come through every week. And you can't ask for better secondary coverage. A few times they've got burned. Paul Singer was picking their pockets a little bit in the secondary earlier in the game. But they got a lot of interception. They played pretty well overall.
That carry by Ricky Davis is going to do it. I'd like to take this time to remind you that the executive producer of Bearcat Football is Dr. Lindsey Pack. We'd like to thank our crew out here today, Mike Sanders and Mike Tyler, for providing all the technical work. Good job today, guys. Appreciate you being with us. The gun sounds and the final score, 42-18. The Bearcats rally behind interceptions in the second half. A great passing day by Reggie Lewis and a good day by Luther Turner, as he had the long touchdown run in the second half, but the interceptions did Paul Singer and the Western Illinois Ball Club in. Don't forget that the Bearcats will be in action in San Marcos, Texas next Saturday as they finish the 1987 campaign at Bobcat Stadium. Kickoff set for 2:00. So for Randy McIlvoy, I'm Rod Sydlik, reminding you that our final score from Bearcat Stadium in Huntsville is Sam Houston State 42, Western Illinois 18. Until next week, so long, everybody.
Huntsville's generous businesses and the Delta Tau Delta fraternity for putting together the homecoming gift package that will be presented to our royalty. Also participating in this afternoon's ceremony are last year's King and Queen, Stuart Brown, senior psychology major from Portland, Texas, and Danielle Woods, junior international business major from Houston. In addition to ending her reign today as homecoming queen, today is a special day for Danielle. It's her birthday. So on the count of three, let's all wish Danielle happy birthday. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Happy birthday, Danielle. Now for the moment, we've all been homecoming king for 1987, Craig Gilcrease. It will be presented gifts in the traditional kiss by Michael Campisi, president of Delta Tau Delta Fraternity, Melissa Ellington. Ladies and gentlemen, your 1987 homecoming royalty. Reflecting the promise and excellence of Sam Houston State University, we present the 1987 edition of the Bearcat Marching Band. Now, the pride of Sam Houston State University, the Blowin' and Goin' Bearcat Marching Band. We'll be right back.
Trombone soloist Ron White and trumpet soloist Mike Wachitra are now featured in the Fifth Dimension Classic, Eli Is Coming. Thank you. the balloon direction, Mr. Rod Cohen. Assistant director is Marley Flyman. Graduate assistant is Mike Corker, and Tom Dollars is the voice of the DMV. The Bearcat Band would like to take this opportunity to welcome back all of its alumni members and thank them for their contributions to the band program at Sam Houston State University.